everybody. So today we are getting ready to do all of our indoor starts for the vegetable garden for this summer. So we've got a few things going on and I'm going to show you. So today I'm setting up, this is the outside part of the greenhouse that it goes inside, but we're setting up the little greenhouse, and we are going to be using these trays to pop in our peat pellet refills, and we're going to get those all nice and plump, and that's what we're going to start all of our seeds in. So I'm going to start getting everything organized and I'll show you how it works as I go. It's possible that I might even divide the greenhouse and the seed starts into two separate videos. So this might be a two-parter. We'll just see. And I'm trying out my ring light for the first time. So we're gonna see how that goes too. It's a little bright, but I think I like it. So let's get started. Okay, so we're going to build the little indoor greenhouse shelves today. I put it right here on this side of the back door because we don't use this side. It's also the biggest window in the house that gets the most amount of light. I don't have a lot of windows that get lots of light because most of the windows are shaded. So it goes here and it's very easy to put together. We've got these two pieces. This is the top and they go kind of like this. And then we've got all these lovely pieces that go in here. And then we've got the sidewall pieces that these are gonna connect into. And they just go boop, boop. And then it goes here. I raise this right up so that way it can get full, full sun. And because it still gets chilly at night, the actual casing for the greenhouse goes around it to protect from the cold and to just keep that heat and humidity in there for those brand new little seedlings that are going to start cropping up in a little while. So I like to get that started on the exact same day that I plant everything, even though the peat pellets with the seeds don't go on here right away. They go on once they start getting leaves. So I'm gonna start building that and we'll see how it goes. That earlier, but it gets quite a bit of light from the south coming in just through the corner. It gets lots of indirect light too. It's almost, it's only shaded in the morning. So the plants do pretty good back here. Sometimes I put them in the front window, but the front window only gets a couple hours of sun. This window gets way, 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 way more. So it's perfect for indoor starts. Plus it's a little out of the way. The kitchen table is right here, but it's easy to get around. It's easy to still have company and things like that. And when everything gets going, I'll have lots and lots of space to do everything, which will be fantastic. And I'm just gonna tuck these trays, because they're not being used yet. They're going to be used in the next week or so, but these ones aren't being used yet, so I'm just going to tuck them in here for storage, because that's a perfect place to put all of my on-the-go planting things, and that's where they'll go for now. Oh, right. Where did I get this? I got this on sale. It was, I think, under $30. It was a clearance item at our old Rona, which we don't have anymore, but you can get these anywhere. It's four shelves. I'm 5'4". This is how tall it is. It's very compact. It would fit nicely in an apartment. If you're going to put it outside, it's okay to put them outside. You want to make sure it's warmer out based on your climate and what your conditions can handle. But if you are going to put it outside, I would highly recommend that if you live in a windy area like I do, I live in Alberta and it's very windy here all the time. If you put something like this outside, I would highly recommend that you stake it and tie it down, or that you tie it down to a fixed structure of some kind, because it will take off in the wind. But for my purposes, I use it indoors for starting all of the seedlings. And as that process goes along, I'll make more videos and show you how I use the greenhouse and how I do my seeds and how I get them ready to go outside and what I do to take care of them. So we're gonna move on to peat pellets and getting the seeds started. Oh, and I forgot to give you guys a little tip. So if the glare, when the sun hits it directly, if the glare is a little too much for you, it will not affect the plants whatsoever, because they're getting all their sun from here. They're not getting any sun from above. It won't affect your plants whatsoever if you put a little tea towel or something over the very top, and I affix it with paper clips, and it blocks the glare from the plastic, from the sun hitting the plastic and going into my eyes all the time. It stops the glare and it makes it so much more enjoyable to have this here in the direct sunlight when there's no glare. All right.